Hello children, I hope you all are keeping well. Let us start with the third chapter, that is algorithm and flowchart. Earlier, we have studied about the first step, that is algorithm. Now, we are going to learn about the second step, that is flowchart. A flowchart is a diagrammatic representation of a problem-solving process, that is algorithm. So children, what we do in this flowchart, whatever steps we write in algorithm, we are going to show them through diagrammatic representation. It is called a flowchart as it charts the flow of a program. The direction of the flow in a flowchart is always from top to bottom. Please remember this, we never go from bottom to top. The flowchart always flows from top to bottom. In a flowchart, each operation is represented using specific geometrical symbols. These geometrical symbols we are going to learn one by one. These symbols are connected to each other by arrows to show the operation. Let us see the geometrical figures one by one. The first one is start and stop box. It is an oval shape figure. That is used at the beginning and the end of the flowchart. It shows the starting and the ending of a flowchart. The second one is input and output box. It is a parallelogram. It is a parallelogram shaped box that is used to indicate the input and the output of a program. The instructions related to the input and getting the results. So whenever we are writing the input or output, we are going to use this box. Children, after this, we are going to learn about the flowchart. We will take one example and we will see how we are using these symbols in the flowchart. The next one is the processing box. It is a rectangle shaped box used to show the processing part of the flowchart, like calculation. Suppose we are calculating the area of a rectangle, so we are going to multiply the length and the breadth in this box. The next one is the decision box. It is a rhombus shaped box used to check the conditions, display comparison, and take the decisions of the problems. We use this in complex problem. Very important are the flow lines. As you can see, these arrows. We use these arrows to connect the different shapes and to show the flow of logic in a flowchart. Now these are connectors. It is a circle-shaped symbol that is used to join the parts of a flowchart. See children, this is the list of the symbols and its meaning. Start and stop box, it is oval shape. It indicates the beginning and the ending of the flowchart. Input output, it is a parallelogram. It indicates the input and output operations and the Next one is the processing that we do it in rectangle. It indicates the calculations and the decisions. It is the rhombus. It indicates the decision making and branching. We use flow lines. It indicates the direction of the flow chart. And we use connector as a circle. It joins one part of the flow chart with another part. Let us learn about the advantages of flowchart. The first one is, it is used in analyzing the problem in a more effective way. It is a better way of communicating the logic of a system. It guides during the program development phase. It is also very helpful in finding out the errors. Children, now let us see the disadvantages of flowchart. The first one is, sometimes the flowchart becomes complex if the program logic is quite long. If you want to change or edit something in the flowchart, you have to redraw it. As we are using the geometrical figures, we have to change the geometrical figure also, and whatever we have written inside it, we have to change that also. Now children, let us see the rules for making a flowchart. We follow certain rules. We will study about it one by one. While drawing a proper flowchart, all necessary requirements should be listed out in a logical order. The flowchart should be clear, neat, and easy to follow. Only one flow line should be used in conjunction with the terminal symbol. The direction of the flow, as you already know, it should be from top to bottom, or it can be from left to right. It cannot be from bottom to top or from right to left. Avoid the intersection of flow lines if you want to make it more effective and better. If the flowchart becomes complex, it is better to use the connector symbols to reduce the number of flow lines. Thank you, children, for watching this video.